Thank you for opening my show.
Sometime last year, I saw a really good Mythbusters show. It really intrigued me. I never stopped thinking about it. It's revolutionary, I think. I think it could change the whole automotive industry for every vehicle that travels on the highway and even airplanes. Well, let me tell you about it. If you don't already know this, a golf ball travels about 30% farther because it has all those little dimples on it. Those little dimples stop the air from being sticky to it. It causes the golf ball to flow through the air without as much aerodynamic drag. It has nothing to do with the fact the golf ball might be spinning.
When air is traveling over a smooth surface, the air likes to stick to that smooth surface, and the faster you go, the more it wants to stick. That's called laminar airflow. If this were like a golf ball, or you took a hammer to the hood and put all kinds of shallow cup-shaped dents into it, then tiny vortices form in those dents as the air is passing across, and it causes the air not to have that laminar sticky flow, so the air flows over much easier, less aerodynamic drag. Well, on Mythbusters, they got a 96 Taurus, one of those rounded body ones with the ugly rounded head, oval headlights, and they coated the whole car with an inch thick of just modeling type clay and carved out a few hundred dimples in it, just like golf ball dimples, shallow dimples. And they tested it before and after, with and without the dimples and with and without the clay.
Well, traveling with that vehicle at about 65 miles per hour, or about 107 or 8 kilometers per hour, that Taurus got 11.4% better fuel economy consistently on the same distance of road they tested it on, and it was even heavier than the car used to be with 600 pounds of clay on it.
That's astounding. Such a simple modification, if it was pressed out on vehicles from the factory, could give you over 11% improvement in fuel economy. Imagine if they did that along the whole fuselage of an airplane.
Or the panels on a great big transport truck, which is a large surface area, were all dimpled like a golf ball too.
Imagine if someone got an 18-wheeler box, you know, 53 foot long, and put all those dimples like Mythbusters did in it. I think that's worth a test. I think that's the most revolutionary fuel-saving invention ever. Why hasn't someone patented that since they did that show? Someone's got to try it. Maybe even just the front end of those transport trucks, since that's the part cutting through the air.
So many of those vehicles, like stock cars, you know, professional stock cars that do circle track racing, imagine their fuel savings and less pit stops and how much faster they could go if they had dimples all over their custom-made bodies. I'm wondering if a simple device could be made that could be fired from using the shell from a nail gun. You know, those shells have no bullet in them or anything, but they have a little bit of gun cotton or gunpowder, if you want to call it that. There's a technology called explosive forming, where they use explosions underwater to press metal objects into shapes. Sometimes very complicated shapes, and it's a cheaper way of making a great big die and pressing machine.
Well, you could have like a cylinder that has like a suction cup around it. You could have water in that cylinder, and in the back end of this cylinder you have just a little hammer, like a trigger, that would hit one of those bullet shells. It's like a bullet shell anyways, and that explosion from that could just put that little cup-shaped dimple into the car or any kind of body. You'd have to do it like really quickly like that to stop all the metal from deforming around it, so it would just do the little dimple right there, right where you wanted it to do it. And then just take an old car like this, or a fleet of old cars. It probably wouldn't even break the paint, and drive for a few months and do some serious real-world testing. We may be onto something. Thanks, Mythbusters.